ऐसा करता था हमें वाले
वाले
ये क्या निकल दिया था आई जो ना ऊपर जाने वाले मतलब ये वो में सीन में अभी करे अभी करता था अभी कैसे दिस में पे
आई करता है वो काम
था वाशे कर ले रहा
हाँ
अंदर ही में इंग्ला वो वाला गुड पेपर भी सुधी इसको ना ये लगता बना बोलो मुगल के नाम से मोड़ दें तो मुझे लाइफस्टाइल का समझ लेने में इंटरेस्ट नहीं है मैं राजस्थान में इसको राजस्थान में कुछ चप्पल नहीं करते राजस्थान के लिए ना उसको मुंबई का वो किस
मुंबई
का वो क्या लगे बीस तो नहीं टेंपल का वो माय कहने
Cuando venga tu hijo.
चहा तू बनवशील का?
तू काय मारा थोडं?
अरे मला लेक्चर करायचं येत
नाही.
अरे बाबा ती वेळ अरे रेकॉर्ड करायचं रे ते मॅम नाव घेते ना
ती नाव घेते तुझं
अरे
Hi guys, good evening. Good evening, everyone. How are you all doing?
Good evening, ma'am.
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 Hey, good evening. Good evening, everyone. So, hope today we have a lot many. So, maybe technical separate and interview separate. Many others have joined the batch, right? Nikhil, Adarsh, Deeksha, Karan, Kishore, Krishna, Lalita, Lavanya, Ruhan, Sandeep, Geeta, Shishank, Shubham, Tishar, Vaibhav, Jyoti. You are all new to this, right? This is your first day with me, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good, good. Can I do your individual, like you are gone through your basics, LMS, and what you have gone through it? Just on your video while you are just mentioning it, okay? one by one, you can just go on like what you have done in the LMS, how much you have completed and all.
Good evening.
Good evening, Diksha.
Yes, ma'am.
So, how much LMS?
Hello?
Yes, yes, please go on.
I have completed my 5% LMS session and now it's my first session with you, ma'am.
Okay, okay, Diksha, okay. Next, Nikhil. Yes, Nikhil.
Ma'am, this is Lalita.
Hi, Lalita.
Ma'am, this is Lalita. I have completed my 10% on LMS.
What are the concepts you have covered?
Ma'am, basics, operators, and Java programming. In Java programming, operators, string, and increment, that is operator, in operator, all operators, relational increment, decrements, greater than, less than, all these topics.
Okay.
And yes, ma'am. I don't remember right now.
That's okay, fine. So basics you have covered, right?
Yes, yes, ma'am. And this is my first session with you.
Okay, that's great. Next, Nikhil, was there Adarsh, Diksha? Still, yep, go on, next. You can volunteer yourself.
Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
My name is Lavanya, ma'am. Ma'am, I completed in LMS 23%, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, this is my first session, ma'am.
Okay, that's great.
Thank you, ma'am.
20%, did you started your programming practice?
No, ma'am, but it's a theory.
Okay.
I still, yes, ma'am, still running on arrays, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So, next.
Yes. Good evening, ma'am. Myself, Kishore Kumar.
Hi, Kishore, good evening.
Completed 7%.
Okay.
This is my first question in class.
Okay, that's fine, Kishore. So basics were done, right? Almost?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's great. That's great. So just try to attend regularly, okay? Yeah, yes, next, ma'am. Go on.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Rohan.
Yes, ma'am. I have completed my basics, ma'am, and still I am in a JDBC topic.
JDBC topics. So
yes, ma'am.
Almost object, OOPs, concepts, classes, objects are done?
Yes, ma'am. I have done. I have completed just now, ma'am.
Okay. That's great. So just join regularly. You'll be having a good practice, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Next.
Good evening, ma'am. I am Sandeep Nage.
Yes. Hi, Sandeep. Good evening.
Ma'am, I completed my Java basic and I started with programming.
Okay, yes, that's great. Next.
My name is Karan Singh and I have completed 4% of LMS course.
Okay, good evening, Karan. So yes, 4%, in the sense, what are the topics you have covered?
Ma'am, I have learned their JVM version of Java and those packages and control statement. And,
okay.
Yes, ma'am. That's the topic.
So until selective controls loops, you have completed, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's great. So next, please go on. Yes, Satyanarayana, you have started to...
Good evening, Satyanarayana.
Good evening.
I have completed 4% of LMS, ma'am.
Okay.
This is not Java.
Okay, similar. Until loops you have done, right?
Yeah, until
loops. Okay, that's great.
And that's also great. I know some basic concepts of Java.
Okay. Still any coding background is there?
What, ma'am?
any coding background do you have, like you're being practicing?
Yeah, I did 3 months of internship in startup company.
Okay, that's great.
Okay, thank you.
Next.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Krishna. Just go ahead.
Yeah, ma'am. I completed basics of Core Java, ma'am. Mm-hmm. But in LMS, I have completed 4% of LMS content.
Okay, that's great. That's great, Krishna. Next.
Hello, ma'am. Good evening. This is Shubham.
Yeah, hi, Shubham. Good evening.
I have completed 5% of LMS, just basics of the Java.
Okay, that's great. Next.
Hello, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. I am Aishwarya. I have completed LMS 96%.
96%. Okay, that's great. That's great, Aishwarya.
Thank you, ma'am.
Next.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Tushar Babar.
Hi, Tushar.
I have completed 50%.
50%. Okay. Halfway ahead. Good.
Thank you.
Next. Yes, guys. Next. Okay, Adarsh.
I'm Adarsh. Junjoy. I have completed 5%.
5% and okay, that's great. Yes. Okay, so is there any next? Okay.
I have completed 45%.
Yes, Ashish, 45%. Okay. New one, whoever joined today, I just want to know from themselves so that we can start. Like from basics or the topics which we can pick up. Still, who were there? Almost Jyoti. Jyoti, you didn't then? Yes, Jyoti. Maybe her audio is a technical issue. That's fine. So, remaining almost all are done, right? So yes, guys, so whoever completed basic things, basically you'll be having like even Hello World program and these all, you'll be having an IDE for practicing. So do you have IDE in your systems, Eclipse IDE?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's great. Yes, so have you started any programming?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you have started programming, right? Okay. So how many programs, like almost like everyone were 4-5% or 10-15%. So some who have completed almost 50% or ahead, like 45-50% and then 96%. Yep, we are having, but almost it's an average of basics were done, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So someone like Oppo, is there like Oppo A53? Who is that? Can you please rename yourself? Oppo A53. I'm just requesting you to unmute yourself. Please try to rename yourself. Okay, fine. So over here, starting like Java concepts, what you are working out is from Core Java, you'll be on working out. So the system over here is, you'll be looking into LMS. Once you have gone through the concepts parallelly, as per technically, I'll be training you completely towards technical. So how the logic you need to apply. And even the questions, I'll be asking interview questions or some sort of games just to make you technically good and to build your logic. So we'll be having 2 hours a session daily. And if you can attend regularly, there are like more chances for you to get succeeded in your interviews. And that is what will be going on. And some of you are already like they were been joining, and whoever joined today who was first session with me, please try to concentrate. I'll be on asking the points. Whatever the points I mentioned, you need to make a note of it. So questions also, please try to make a note of it. Okay. And as like many were there, so I'll be start with the basic thing. I hope Oppo A53 still you didn't change. Try to change it with your name. We'll get into it. So please try to open your Eclipse. Open your Eclipse. And whenever your LMS, whenever your LMS, when you're going on, try to work it out practically. So you'll, when first suppose like a topic is done, like variables or data types, a small basic topic which is done. What you need to do is you need to practice it in your Eclipse. It's nothing but like you are just going on practicing. So that practicing makes you just good in this session, because once you practice, I'll be asking what snippets which will be coming up like in your interviews, whatever they ask, showing you a code and giving you some time, like 5 minutes or 2 minutes to solve it and ask you to tell the output. So this is what just the process goes on. It's a couple of, it's not that every interview will have code snippets, and it's not that every interview will not have. So it depends. So basically, perspective is whenever you look onto Java code, you should be able to crack the result. And even you should be able to understand each and every line of the code, what you are using. What you are using. So this is what happens. So what you need to do is, practice is important. You need to practice whatever you learn from the LMS. And even here we'll be drilling you whatever the concepts you have gone through the LMS. If you face any difficulty in any topic, if you can't get it up through LMS, you can clear it up over here. I'll be taking up that concept. I'll make you understand it very clearly. So is that clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, then that's yes, it. And yeah, good. And one more thing, you need to be very responsive. You need to give response with a yes or no. If you didn't work it out, like if I give any assignments to you, if you can't work it out, some issue, you need to give the response. You need to give the response like, due to some issue, I could not work. Some technical issue, I did not work. Or I didn't get it, the code. I can't crack the code. So that thing, you need to mention it clearly. So if you mention this kind of issues, I'll be here to help you out. So please don't get the code from any web sources. Try to solve by yourself. Try to apply logic. I'll be here for helping you out for applying the logic. So it's nothing but like for your success, we'll be helping you out. Even the same effort I just want from you. Yeah. So it's first day. They were, who wants to know my name? So I'm Sneha. Can we go? So I'm Sneha. I'm training as a corporate trainer, and even I'll be make you prepare for the interviews and all. So yes. So is there anyone left over who wants to introduce yourself? Like who wants to tell me like how much percentage you have covered? It's nothing but whenever just open up at the first attempt, it makes somewhat free, like comfortable with me, so that you can ask any doubts ahead.
Hello, ma'am. This is Shashank.
Hi, Shashank.
Hi, ma'am. Good evening. I completed 10% of our course. I started joining in last week.
So okay.
This was my this is my third lecture with you and milestone also.
Okay. That's great. Still anyone else?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Abhijit.
Ma'am, I have completed one assignment where I will send it.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
I am Rinit. I have completed 25% in LMS.
Okay, that's great. So almost you have covered all the concepts.
Yes, ma'am. Basic some concepts of OOPs and loops. Control structure statements and all.
Okay. That's great. So here, everyone have completed the basic Hello World code and everything, right? So what I'll do is, I just want, let me share the eclipse. So I just want you to give individual statement meaning, individual keyword, what you are using for the basic hello world, whatever you have performed. Because as it is the first day for you all, like some of most of the people, and it would be a drill for the others, what we are using, what is a basic main function, what is the words we are using, and everything will be completely from basics. Let's just come up. So I'm just sharing my screen. Don't give answers at a time. I'll just call you up for giving the answers. If I just tell that question is to all, then you can come up. I'll see like who are answering. Yeah. So let me just share the screen. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, good. Good, good. So I'm expecting answers from the one who have joined today. Clear? Hope it's clear to you. And coming to others like who are already have been a part, like as I told, you need to be perfect, or you need to be go through the connectivities, JDBC or HyperNet, from Java to database connectivities, like Aishwarya, Sudhir, Sridhar, and a couple of others members, right? So what you need to do is, meanwhile, just write a code on this connectivity. Clear? Write a program to establish. I need to see all the operations from front end to back end. That means from Java to database, you need to manipulate it. Insert operation, update operation, all the operations. And remember, whatever you use, I'll ask each and individual word logic and even the usage, why you are using it. For example, you are using prepared statement. So each and individual, whatever you're using, I'll ask it. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So you want me to read the names, or you know it? You know it, right? Who are them?
Yes, ma'am.
So they're Sridhar, and then Aishwarya, Mohanta, Suresh Babu, Gauri. So who are been joining these many days, you have to work on the connectivity. Just write a code for that. Meanwhile, so I'll just go through the basic concepts. Then we'll get back to you. Yes, remaining everyone. So here you have gone through all the basic scenarios, basic concepts, like almost I didn't see anyone less than 4%. So 4% of LMS is the least, and everyone operators, data types, and then variables were the basic things which you have covered. And many of them have even covered until loops. So here, I'm not asking a very lengthy, I'm not entering into the topic, just a basic thing. What we'll be using is the first main thing, or public class, and then import Java. These are the lines which, you know, basically we'll be using while coding purpose. So now I need you, to start from this import. What is this basically? Import java.util.scanner. Okay, this is user input. If you didn't across this, that's fine. But whoever is going on with selective statements like 5%, 7%, 15%, selective statements, they'll be having an idea what exactly is a scanner and why you are importing. And individually, I require, not like it's a scan and we are just using for user input. I don't want that one or two lines. I want in depth what exactly you're using it in technical terminology. Clear? So now, who are ready to give answers? So I just want this complete third line description, why you are using it, even what is java.util.scanner, individual things. Please raise your hands. Who wants to give the answer? Yes. Who want to give? Nobody across user input? Yeah, one raising we just got, Kishore.
It is using to get the input from the users.
That is what I told. No one line or two lines, like using user input. No. Okay, fine.
Scanner is the package one. That's why we are using the scanner.
Scanner is a package.
Scanner is a class, ma'am.
Ma'am, scanner is a class, ma'am.
That's correct. Scanner is a class.
Class.
Scanner is a class which is used to get the input, and java.util is the package.
Mm-hmm.
We are going
okay.
to
import it. Yep. Almost technical terms, you have got it. Somewhat clear, please.
Hello, ma'am. This is Lalita.
Yes. Yes, ma'am, Lalita.
Input is a keyword which is used to import the package. And util is a predefined package, and scanner is a class. Scanner is class is used to take input from the user.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am, I'm done.
Okay, that's great, guys. So here, basically, why we require Java code over here? It's not only Java, any language code. We are communicating to system. So we required a language. So we are going with from C++ to Go on. We are just going on languages, right? So this packages, classes, and everything. Did you ever think why these all required? Why these all required? So just give me a moment. Then you will understand why exactly these all required. So over here, you need to understand something. When you and me are communicating, in what language we are communicating? In English, right? So how we know this English to us? We have some inbuilt mother tongue or somewhere we have learned, or else if you just pick foreigners from basic, they have learned English itself and then they understand it. So in the same way, we have machine code over here for systems. And then a common language like we are going in English, where both can understand. Even your mother tongue is some Canada and my mother tongue is some Tamil or some Telugu. We are communicating in English. It's a common platform for us to understand. In a similar way, system and we are having a common platform, coding programming language. This is a common platform where system will understand, where I will understand. So how the system make it understand? It's a machine, right? Basically, how it will understand. The language it knows is zeros and ones, machine language, completely machine language, right? So for example, I'm having a mother tongue and I'm having English, right? So in here, If you pick a word, learn. So in the same way, this meaning is being linked up to my mother tongue. So I use my brain as a translator as I'm analyzing from the start so that it will just translate it to my own language and I'll understand it. So that's a scenario which happens in the similar way, And here you need to remember one more thing, how it will analyze, how it will handle these many words, these many things. It has like, you know, sentences, words. It won't remember all these is the sentence for this. This is a word for this. It just try to know the meaning and understand. So all the words, yes, this is the meaning of the word. When it becomes a sentence, it will analyze and generate the meaning from it. That happens in the brain, right? So here, storage of this meanings and words would be a section in the brain. So that is general human conversation. In a similar way, system is going on with the translation of programming language to its own machine language. So for that, what it required? It required every meanings, every tasks to be loaded inside it. That task or that meanings, we call it as packages. Inbuilt packages, inbuilt libraries. So whatever we do, we are not discovering something over here already available. We are making use of it. Everything is already available. We are just making use of it. That is the reason. If you just want any user input, That means, see, I just don't know your name and your details. What I'll do? You'll just tell me your name and details. What I'll do? I'll just store accordingly. Like if you tell me your date of birth, I'll calculate and I'll tell you age. In the similar scenario, if I want system to perform this task, system required date of birth. That is user input, what you are giving to system. It will calculate and it will give you age as an output. So here the user input is whatever our requirement we are coded. So we are giving user input to analyze and calculate, and then we are getting output. That is what user input. So over here, to get this user input, whatever typed from the keyboard, to get this user input, we are not creating something new. A package java.util is already existed. It is having lot many classes. For user input especially, scanner is a class used for user input. So we are making use of that class. As Java is objects and classes, that means completely object oriented. It's not 100%, but objects and classes. Everything if you want to communicate in Java, you will be having classes. You need to create an object and you need to call the methods through objects. Methods will exist in the class. And after creating object, this object, use of object, you will call methods. Then they will be executing. This is what happens in Java. Similarly, even for inbuilt classes also, same version. Whatever the class exists inbuilt, you need to create an object. Then you need to use that object, make use of that object to perform or to call methods. This is what happens. Same thing we are doing over here. Scanner is an inbuilt class. We have created object for this particular scanner class using new keyword, And you can just see, okay, fine. This is fine. Importing is clear. Scanner, yep, create an object is clear. Then what is this? System.in. What is this? Observe here.
Keyword.
Just a keyword, system.in. Observe carefully. Understand individual. You need to understand. Because in the interviews, if you just give a one-line answer, like it won't be. You have to understand, give the logic inside why you are using, for what you are using.
And system is a class from lang package. And in is a variable. Sorry, in is an object of that class.
Observe carefully. System class contains several useful class fields and methods, right? It cannot be initiated among the facilitators, right? It is standard input and standard output and error output streams. So class dot, and what is this in? Input stream, right? Observe carefully. Individually, I'm just trying to explain. Observe it. The stream already open. Typically, the stream corresponds to input, to keyboard input. Now, this is a class. You only mentioned it's a class. Okay, that's fine. System is a class, right? Class dot, what you are giving, what is this in then?
In is an object, ma'am.
Is it an object? Are you sure? Think properly. Using new keyword, you have created an object SC, right? For the scanner class. Scanner is a class which you have imported, and making use of that class, you are creating an object over here using new keyword, right? So here, what is this? Basically, what is the system.in?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, system is a class from lang package,
and in is a static variable. So hence we are calling the static variable of type input stream type.
Mm-hmm.
Hence we can call that variable by using class name, that is a system dot in.
Okay, so you are finalizing like your answer, like in is a variable, right? Is it a variable?
Static variable.
Static variable.
Of type input stream type.
Of input stream type.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Any other answers? Just try it up. You need to try it. Even if it's wrong, that's fine. Yeah, just learning it, right? So now it's wrong, that's fine, but it should not be wrong in the interview. So try it up. What is this? System.in.
Ma'am.
Only Lalita has been. Yes, Tushar.
System.in is a input string to use access the value.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, sir. Ma'am. Access the value.
Okay, okay. So what you tell, in is an object or in is a variable or in what exactly dot in? System, okay, you have told it's class. Okay, agreed, it's a class. Then what is this dot in? And here also you are just having out. You are having out. In the same way here you are having in. What is this in?
In is a static variable.
Yes, Abhijit.
In is a static variable inside system. In system mm-hmm. class.
Okay. So ma'am, it's a static variable in system class, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So two answers for static variable still.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Ritan, please go on.
Ma'am, that actually tells the compiler that you have to take input from a console, where that out tells the compiler that you have to print something on the console.
Okay, okay. So what is this in? Is it like, can we take it as a variable or a method? What exactly?
Yes, ma'am. I think it's a variable.
It's a variable. Okay.
Yes.
It's a variable. Okay, fine. Still any other answers? Still, I want everyone involvement. That's the reason I'm asking.
In is the method, ma'am.
Jyoti, in is a method. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Still? Still?
Hello.
Yes, Gulshan.
Ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
In is a static variable of type input stream.
Okay.
And system is a class.
Okay.
System input will provide the
mm-hmm.
input through keyboard.
Okay. Still, that's it. I'm expecting some more answers.
Ma'am, if we are talking about system.in, so ma'am, this is the parameter
mm-hmm.
for a scanner class. And if okay. we are just saying systems, ma'am, system is a class and ma'am, dot in is a static variable. Ma'am, the type of input string. Ma'am, dot in.
Okay, fine. So now I'll just give you exactly about what is this system.int. Okay, so here Java scanner, yes, we already know scanner is a class, right? So in this line, what we are using is we are creating an object for this inbuilt class. And Java is inbuilt class. We are not created the class. It's an inbuilt class and we are creating object for that class using new keyword. Here, a new scanner and system.in. Here the topic is about system.in. What is the system.in? Basically, to get the instance of Java scanner which reads input from user, we need to pass the input stream system.in in the constructor of scanner class. So basically, over here, whenever you create an object, an instance will be done. That means default constructor will be created and called. So to pass through that constructor, argument kind of thing, system.in. What is this argument? System.in, in the sense, it has to take input from keyboard. That is what over here the complete description. If you want output from the system, then you need to go with system.out. You can tell it as a static variable. You can tell it as a parameter. You can tell it as argument. Basically, the task over here is it has to take input from user. And where you are giving and why you are giving the system.in over there, when you create an object, it creates a default constructor. And you're passing the system.in into the default constructor. Why you're passing the system.in in the default constructor is this will make activate to take input from the keyboard. Input from the keyboard or from the keyboard, whatever you give input. Clear? Yes, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Unmute yourself. And if possible, please try to on your videos. Okay. So here, I hope it's clear what is system.in. And then similarly, system.out. System is a class. Dot out. You can just make it as an object or output stream. It will go with the print. And if you can see over here, print ln, it's nothing but not only ln, after print you'll be having many other things, but we are using ln. So if not just normal print also you can just use. It's a method basically. What is this print ln? Is a method. Whatever you give inside this method in the double quotes, it will print as it is. And if you want to print 2 to 3 printing statements, then you need to give string in a double quotes as it is, then concatenation symbol plus, then it will print the digits, or again if you want to go with string, again in double quotes. So this is how the operation. It's a method. Println is a method. And coming to int. Int a equals to sc dot next int. What is this particularly? What is this? Can anyone just go on? Int a, that's fine. We are declaring a as an integer. Not an issue. And what is this?
SC is the object of scanner class.
Yes. Excellent. SC is an object of scanner class. That's clear. So using object, what it is calling?
Method.
What is that method name?
Next int
is a method. For what this method is used?
To take integer input from user.
That's it. Excellent. To take integer input from the user. If you want input as string, what you need to use?
Next line you can use
for text or integer. So, is it clear about the input?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, this input and everything, that's fine. But I do have a lot of doubt about this main. What is this public?
Access specifier.
Why you are specifying that access? Why you are going with the public? Why can't you go with the private? Why can't you go with protected? Why are you going with only public?
Because we can access anywhere in any project.
Anywhere?
Within
that. No, I didn't get a clear answer. Only a couple of members are answering. Please try to involve everyone. Why? Why only public?
Free public. Main method can be defined as free public in project class.
Still?
Java is a public method.
Still?
Accessing whole program.
Accessing whole program? Still? I didn't get the right answer.
Yes, ma'am. This is Lalita. Ma'am, public is an access specifier. JVM has to call main method, hence it is public because it is global access specifier.
Okay. Why only JVM you are having in Java? JRE and JDK, why can't they can do the task?
It is a platform independent, ma'am. Everyone can access.
Platform independent, nowhere related.
It is scope.
Ma'am, JRE comes under the JVM. Ma'am, JRE comes under the JVM.
JRE comes under the JVM. Okay. So what all JVM does and what all JRE does? What are JVM does and what are JRE does? What is this basic difference between JDK, JRE and JVM? How the execution process goes on in Java? If you know these answers, then you will get to know what exactly public.
Ma'am, JDK is a Java development kit. If you want to develop program, then we have to install JDK. And if you want to only run the program, then we have to install only JVM.
No. In JDK itself, JRE will be there. In JRE itself, JVM will be there.
Yes, ma'am. But if you want to develop and run, then we want JDK.
Develop and run, then you want JDK.
Yes.
Okay.
JDK is a compiler.
If you
JDK is a collection of libraries packages. So we need to
Somehow. Shubham, can you please somewhat clear it up? JVM is or JDK is collection of?
It's a collection of libraries and packages.
Languages and packages.
Libraries.
Libraries and packages. Okay. Okay. Fine. Still?
JDK is a toolkit.
Toolkit. Okay. Still?
JDK is write and execute the program.
Write and execute the program. Okay. Still?
And it's contents in JRE.
Still?
JRE is the set of libraries required by JVM to execute a code.
Okay. So you are trying a lot for the answers, but no correct answers. Let me just share my Word document. You have tried a really very good way. But you need to know some more depth in what is JDK, what is JRE, and what is JVM. So after knowing that, you need to know what is execution steps in Java. And then you will get to know what exactly main, how it will be working up. So let me just share the other screen. So here, everyone, can you please go through your C drive? Open your C drive. Go on. Did you open? unmute yourself on your videos.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In the C drive, you'll be having program files, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In the program files, you'll be having Java. Java or JDK?
JDK.
What you're having?
JDK.
So in the program files, you'll be having JDK. Java will be there, and inside the Java, you'll be having JDK, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And JRE folders also will be there. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So now just open JDK. Then you'll be having like bin, include, and JRE is there inside it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you having JRE?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now just minimize that particular folder. Cleared, minimized?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, listen to me clearly, carefully, because these are very, very basic things which you need to know before Java. Even scanner and all these classes, you need to know this difference and the execution steps, how execution will be done in Java, and then you will understand everything from now. So now, basically, JVM is Java Virtual Machine. Whenever someone asks you what is JVM and all, so you should not tell JVM is a task which is mean by executing and all. It's a Java Virtual Machine. Clear? It's a Java Virtual Machine, and it is called a virtual machine because why it is called? That also you need to know. Why is it called? So it is called because it doesn't exist physically. Can you see JVM in Java folder? You can see JDK, and inside that you can see JRE. Can you see JVM? Just now you have opened, right? No, physically JVM is not exist. It is specification that provides a runtime environment in which Java bytecode will be executed. Not Java program, Java bytecode, only bytecode, machine code will be executed. So it's not that only Java programs, anything which exists in that bytecode, it will be executed through JVM. Anything, that is what it is, platform independent. And even any code, so not only like if you're having JRE, you can run Jenkins in it, you can run your Eclipse in it, you can add SonarQube, you can go with many other software applications on Java. Because we are having JVM, So once you write, you can run anywhere in the Java features just because of JVM. Since it's a virtual machine, it is executed only bytecode. It doesn't execute your program. It will execute bytecode. So we are writing programs and we are just clicking on execute in Eclipse, but you're getting output. It's not. It's only two-step execution is going on. So first, listen about this JVM, JRE, JDK. Then I'll explain two-step of execution, what it is. Okay, so JVM is available for many hardware and software. It's not that you can have JVM for Windows and for Apple, it's not having. No, for Mac, Windows, and Linux, Unix, for every kind of operating system, JVM is available. And what is the main task for this JVM? We can't see physically. So what perform, what it does? What it does in the Java code? What it does in Java programming? This is a doubt or this is a question maybe asked in the interview. You need to be ready for this. That's the reason you need to understand. So here, JVM performs, first thing, it loads the code. What code it loads? It loads bytecode. It doesn't load your Java program code. It is loading only bytecode and verifies bytecode, whether it is in correct format or not. Then
executes that code. Then executes that code. After execution, it will provide runtime environment for this bytecode. For that bytecode, it will provide runtime environment. Runtime environment. This is what four tasks which is performed by KVM. First thing, it will load the code. It is responsible to load bytecode. Again, I'm mentioning it is bytecode, not Java program code. It is bytecode. Then it verifies that bytecode, executes that bytecode, and provides runtime environment for that bytecode to give you result. To give you result. Now, that's fine. JVM, we got it. And then what is this JRE? What is this JRE? So JRE is runtime environment for Java. Java runtime environment. It's a set of software tools which are used for developing Java applications. So someone told JDK is a kit where we can develop Java, applications and all. JRE, you require JRE. That means runtime environment you required. So here this is responsible and it is nothing but set of software tools which were used for developing applications. It is the implementation of JVM. So JRE and JVM, it's not separate thing. JVM logically does all the tasks, loading the code, executing bytecode, giving runtime environments. This is does. How it is giving runtime environment? The implementation done through JRE. That is the reason we can say JRE as a physically, but we can't say JVM. It's a logically exist. It's a virtual machine. So you can't see logic. You can't see it in a folder format. That is the reason over here in the first diagram about JRE, you are having a JVM inside. And the implementation of this JVM, that is JRE, through set of libraries, RT jar files and other files. You can see this jar files. If you open JRE folder, you can see all the jar files over there. You just open your Java and then JDK and inside it JRE, inside it bin, you can have or you can go with the libraries where you'll be having JFR, jar file, JFC files, and then you can see lot of files will be there. Everything is jar files. So what are these files basically? What are these files basically does? See, jar files is for runtime. It gives you runtime. See, in Eclipse, if you want to go with MySQL, you require MySQL connector jar file. If you want to go with MySQL, say Java, you'll be writing database connectivity like code. If you want to connect with this MySQL, you require jar files to be loaded. If not, it won't be working. This is external jar files where you'll give to IDE. This is how. So when a program to run, you require some files supported to that program. Those are jar files. That files it will be giving up. Libraries, yes, we already know standard libraries used for program to be used, like in a scanner, everything, every classes, every libraries which were existing. Standard libraries, set of libraries will be containing in JRE. That's fine about JDK and JRE. Now the task was. Now the task was, my screen, is it sharing?
No.
No, right, lol. That is what I have a doubt, like it got stopped or what, yeah. Now is it visible? Hopefully, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So yeah, now that is about JR. Now comes, what is this JDK then? What is this JDK? JDK, yes, it's a set of complete JRE plus development tools like Java C and then Java and all. These all commands will be there in JDK. All the commands. So it's a development kit, complete kit. So here, you know, it contains basically Java C and Java. That means Java is interpreter. Interpreter or loader, you can just tell. And Java C is compiler. compiler. That is the reason two step of execution, which I told, right, we'll discuss all later. Now it's the time to discuss. Now, in development kit, you'll be having Java C, that is compiler. What is the task of Java C? Whatever code you are writing, that code, when you execute with Java C and file name, what it does is it will execute this code and make it into byte file, that is class file. Right? So if you can perform in command prompt, like writing in the notepad, and if you can perform in the command prompt Java C, after compilation, a class file will be generated. That is nothing but bytecode. That is nothing but bytecode. And next, Java is interpreter. Java space class file, again, class name you'll be given. Why you'll give class name over here? Now you are executing class file, not the code what you have written. You have compiled the code to bytecode. This bytecode will be executed. That is the reason two step of process. You will first compile it, then interpret it. Compile is Java C command and interpreter Java command. Compilation Java C space file name. File name. File name you need to give. Java file name, source file name. Like abc.java. And file name and class name should be similar. Similar. For sure, like wherever you mention main method, that class name should be the file name. Then, after converting it to class file, in Java place, Java space class name you need to give, not file name. Class name you will be given. Dot Java you won't be given. So first you will be compiling, then you will be interpreting. So this is the reason two step of execution will be there in Java. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So now let me share my Eclipse. So now, here comes public. Now about public. Here, I ask in-depth like explanation, right? Why it has to be public and all. Because your execution starts with this line, with this main function, main method. With this line, your execution process starts. If your execution starts with here, if you are giving as private or protected, it won't be visible by JVM because it is two-step of execution. Why it is two-step? It will first convert the program to class file, bytecode, and then this will be executed. So it should be visible. Basically, JVM has to have visibility to this file. So you need to give it as public. That is the reason scope of public is almost it will be visible. Right? That is what the scope, right? If you're giving access modifier, access specifier, you'll be calling different names. But the thing is, JVM should reach to this file as this is first step of execution. That is the reason always you should mention it as public. Just you're making this program scope for execution. This is the first step of execution. And then comes with static. So, coming to static, as I discussed, like if you're having a class like scanner, what you're doing, you're creating a objects. So everything in Java without creation of object, you can't execute it. Now the class basic is there. So in the basic class, if I want to create an object, it won't execute. But my starting step is main method. Main method. So I need to avoid this creation of object. That is what I'm using static. So if I make this method as a static, what happens is without creation of object, it starts execution. So whenever a method is static, it don't require any creation of object. That is the reason we are making it as a static. Now, void. For what we'll be using void? This answer I'm expecting from you.
It is not returning any.
No returning value. No returning value.
Why is return?
You don't want return from the main.
No, ma'am. That is the return type.
It's present return type value, ma'am.
return type value.
Yes.
Now, it is a return type of then modify. So what is return? See, you told no return type or no return value. Value won't be written. So if it is return type, no return type is different from return value. Think and give exactly. What exactly you want to tell? Is it a return type or return value?
Value, ma'am.
Return value, ma'am.
Return type, ma'am.
Return type, ma'am. When is a method and what is its return type?
Return type, ma'am.
Type or value?
Value, ma'am.
Type.
Return type, ma'am.
What is a return type?
Value. Okay, okay. So void is a return type and void is a return value. We are having both the answers. So
void
is a return
type. Mean, void is a return type and it does not return anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Still? Still anyone else answers?
Function got return value, ma'am.
Does not return anything, ma'am.
Does not return anything. Okay. Still.
Return type, ma'am. Why is it return?
Still, I'm just expecting a lot more. Okay, fine. Basically, both are correct. Void is a return type of the method. It is a return type of the method. See, for method, before method, you are mentioning void. It means it's a return type. What type required to return by the method? It's a return type. Then, it also means that it doesn't return any value. That means if you use value, if you use void, it doesn't return any value. And it's a return type for the method. So now here you have to understand, if you use int display or int some main. So it's a method which is having return type as int and it is returning integer value. Integer value. If you're giving float, float space method name like display and giving the details. The method having float type of data, return value will be in the float. In the same scenario, if you're making void, void is a return type of that method. It doesn't return any value. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear to everyone?
Yes.
But ma'am, why main method is not returning anything?
See, it is not returning anything in the sense, what is main function task?
To start the program, execution of program.
Start the program, execution starts there, right? So whatever you are having the steps, it has to execute that steps, right? Yes or no? Yeah. So now, if you give some return value through that main function, basically it has to do the task whatever mentioned. It should not return a value again. It should do the task whatever mentioned. If it is returning some 10, some string, some other things, if it is returning, how could that come a main thing? Main method is execution has to happen. All the lines has to be executed. And in Java, everything, you have to have an object. Through object, you will call a method like obj.display. Whatever existing in that method, that will be executed. That is what. And here, there is no method, no object to call. No object to call. And if it is returning some value, we should not restrict it to that value. We require complete execution. We require everything, whatever we return, we write, it has to execute it. So we should not expect only a little value from that. It's a main method. It's not a normal method for having operations. That is a reason if we are having a return type from main, we are just restricting that main only to that return value. So that is not the task of main basically.
Are you getting my point? Yes.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, yeah, that is about me. So this all fine. That's fine. I have a doubt. Where this main method is existing?
In JVM, ma'am.
In JVM?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
JVM can invoke.
Yes, sir.
So whatever you make it as a static, everything invoked by JVM itself, because no objects has been required. And as it is public and it is completely static, no return type, everything task performed by JVM. So main exists in JVM. And then what is a string?
Command, ma'am, command line argument, ma'am.
Command line arguments. Why you're passing this basically through this method main?
Ma'am, accept some data.
Accept all the value, ma'am. Accepting the all values.
Ma'am, we can pause
it, the... it can be access all the values and define all the values. Like number of values. Number of...
Okay, okay.
Without it, we cannot run the program.
Okay.
It can compile, but it cannot run.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Still. Basically, you are passing string in the form of array and args you are passing, right? So here, why you need to go only with the strings? My doubt is, why can't I pass integer to each? Why can't I pass integer instead of string?
Ma'am, string is a mostly common use in
Think. Through main method, I'm passing these values, but I'm passing only string. If I just want integer to be passed, can I pass it? And why it is only string?
In Java, everything should be string, ma'am.
Everything should be string. So we can't use any integer in Java. Think.
That means Java 90% objects are string objects only.
Simple logic, guys. Here, if you're making it as a string, if you're passing string, obviously numeric letters also will be embedded in string itself. If you make any data type in the string, can't you pass numeric to it? Oh no, it will accept. Simple thing. See, you have to understand exactly why it is using. That's it. So string is a class where it will allow only strings. Completely in string it will be passing. Here, I do have one more doubt. String array symbols are there. Args, nothing. If I just keep args like this square brackets beside args, is there any difference between the first one and the second one?
No, ma'am.
Are you sure?
Family, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
It's asking me to enter a number. Entered number is 45. But I don't accept your answer. There is difference. By changing this square brackets, we have lot of difference. Think. Anyone wants to try to answer this question? Just make it right.
there is a difference. Do you want to know?
Yes, ma'am.
There is a difference. Here, if you are keeping this array symbols beside strings, what happens is, what you're passing is like in an array format, sequence of characters, that means sequence of words you're passing. Like this is a single word, is, just, a, test, like many, many sequence, complete sequence of words you're passing in the form of all the strings in the form of array you're passing. In a form of array, if you keep this square brackets beside strings. In the same way, if you just keep the square brackets beside auths, then all the character lengths you're passing, like A, B, C, characters are being passed in the form of characters. The square brackets, if you keep beside string, then complete words sequence of complete words, it's passing. That is a difference. So don't tell that there is no difference. There is a difference. Clear? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So you hopefully main method is clear to you.
Yes.
Now comes with this output. Yes, this method output is also clear to you, and input is also clear. Is there any doubt in this input and then output scanner class? Any doubts, user input? Any doubts?
Ma'am.
Yes, Lavanya, do you have a doubt?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it's a package Java project, ma'am. That first one, ma'am.
First one.
Java project.
So this line you want to know, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So import java.util you have performed, right? So this import java.util is a package. You can see this is a package.
Yes,
you can see the some square symbols and a cross were there. This is a package. And this is a class existing in this particular package.
Yes,
okay, in the same scenario, this is system package. This is system classes, right? Means already existing in the system. We are just utilizing it. In the same way, every class, whatever we perform, will exist in a default package. If this particular thing, if we import this package like a Java project package, then we will be able to load the methods or functionalities exist in this package. We can import even this package in other package and we can see the difference. So user defined packages can also be imported, not only system defined packages. Any class should have by a default package. You can't go a single class without a package. Any class will exist in a package. So if you want to make use of that class, make use of the functionalities of the class, make use of methods existing in that class, you need to call that class by the package. Package.class. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Is it clear? The basic code?
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can you please explain system.in again, why it is written with a scanner in an object of a scanner? Yes, ma'am.
System.in. Okay, clear. So here, basically, when you are creating an object for the scanner class, a default constructor is being created. It's a special method. So this constructor will be expecting some parameters should pass through. That parameters are system.in. Why we are passing only system.in is it will enable user input. It is a functionality where it will accept input from keyboard. That is the reason you are making it as system.in. System is a class where dot in, you can make it as a static variable or method. The performance of this combination system dot in is it will enable user input from the keyboard. And same scenario, system dot out. That means out is a method or a variable you can consider, but system class out task is, it will print from the system's analysis to the screen, to the user, and through which method you are having still methods inside it. Clear? So now, here the exact explanation is system class dot out object dot calling method println. Okay, inside the method, whatever you need to use in double quotes, message printing, plus some concatenation, you can print lot of things inside it. It's already that we can pass strings, and even with concatenation, you can pass many of the things inside it. But basically what you need to understand is what is out, in the sense you can make it as object for system class. Through this object, it's calling a method println. Right? You can see over here, standard output stream. It will be open and ready to accept output data. It is accepting output data. From where it is accepting? From the system perspective, it is accepting and printing to us. In the same way, in is nothing but standard input stream. Standard input stream. So this stream is already open. You are making it as open. That means you are just opening a stream for input. You are just opening a stream for output. Somewhere securitily, you are just opening by using of these classes and methods, and you are making your user input. So you're not doing your own thing already existing. You are making use of it. Okay. Yes, so remember, ma'am, in this perspective, if anyone asks, you need to tell that system is an inbuilt class. Out is an object used to call println method. Okay. So you need to give in this format.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, default constructor is a zero parameterized constructor, ma'am. Then how can you pass the arguments?
No. Default constructor never be zero parameterized constructor. It is having some default value. And this is not a static method where you can't change a value. So whenever you pass something, it will accept it. It becomes parameterized constructor. You can have parameterized constructor while creating of object. You can have default. When there is no, nothing is there inside it, system.in, nothing is there. Only brackets is there. Then it is default. No values are there. If you're having some arguments, it becomes parameterized. Because the method or the class, everything is not static. You can reuse of it. If it is a static, then that makes an issue where you won't create an object or where you don't have any constructors. Clear, okay. Krishna?
Okay.
Yeah, if it's clear, we just go on to the next thing. Is it clear? Any doubts?
No.
Yes, everyone. Any doubts?
No.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No. So now let me stop screen sharing and let's have a basic questionnaire patch. Basic questionnaire on the topics which we have discussed right now from the interview perspective. So, what is Java?
Java is an object-oriented programming language.
Mm-hmm. Yes, working on the connectivity, you also can include in this questionnaire part. I want everyone to be included. Yes, Sudhir, Aishwarya, Sridhar, Gulshan, and all others, please try to involve in this, okay? Yeah. What is Java? I don't want single word object oriented or high level.
Java is a
programming language.
And Java is a platform independent.
High level programming language and also platform independent.
So object oriented programming language and used for the multiple applications like web application, mobile applications, enterprise applications, and it's having different editions of enterprise standard.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ma'am, Java is a high level class based object oriented programming language.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No confidence. No confidence. See guys, you are this thing that every question is asked in the form of interview. You need to give complete technical terminological answer. You know the concept? Yes, accept it. But how I can understand in this meanwhile that you know the concept? You need to present it in the form of your answers. Try to give your answers in that scenario.
Hello.
Hello. Java is a high-level programming language which works with classes and objects.
Okay. Still. Fine.
And Java is an object-oriented yes? programming language. It was developed mm-hmm. in 1991. It's simple, secure, and it made for the web kind of application. This language is matlab this language
mm-hmm. okay.
Java is a high level programming language. It is mm-hmm. object oriented and it is a platform independent programming language.
Fine. You need to give complete features of Java whenever they ask you what is Java, because there you will have just a couple of minutes to showcase your complete knowledge. And this is very basic question. If you just give Java is a high level programming language, or if you just give it's object oriented, no, that never completes. You need to grab your interviewer's attention and you need to show that yes, you have confidence on your answer and you know the concept of Java completely, so that I can give more. In that scenario, your answer should be like Java is a high-level, object-oriented, robust, secure programming language, platform-dependent, high-performance, multi-threading, and portable programming language. It was developed by James Gosling in June 1991. It can also be known as a platform, and it provides its own JRE and API. These two are the terminologies which you need to use it. And everything in Java will be performed in the form of objects and classes. So whatever you want to exist, whatever you want to execute it, you should have a class and you need to create object. Through the object, you can call the methods embedded in the class and you can execute the code. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Got it? So understand. See, why I'm giving from the basic itself, why I'm giving you a drill is, so whenever you face interview question on these basic questions, you need to be answering very confidently. You need to know how you need to answer it. Yes, guys. So your next question. Ma'am, on what parameters we can say Java is secured programming language? On what parameters you can say secure programming language? Okay, fine. So I'll just give to you itself. Who wants to answer this question?
Ma'am.
Yes, Aishwarya, go on. On what parameters you can just tell Java is secure?
Ma'am, sorry, ma'am, but I was asking the question, ma'am. I am connectivity problem. Ma'am, program can give you some error. That's why I am. Ma'am, program can give the error. Ma'am, I am inside the record, employee record, but ma'am, these are not executed in properly.
Okay, your program having some error, so you want to ask. Okay. Yes, what's ma'am. The error you got? Just share your screen. Let me sort it out.
Ma'am, some network issue. That's why I am sharing the photo for WhatsApp group. Can you
okay. You know my details, like you can share in WhatsApp or you want to share in chat?
Yes, ma'am, message share.
Okay, okay, share it up.
I am connected with my mobile because ma'am, I have shared photo for computer.
Okay, okay. Okay, fine, share it up. Share it up through WhatsApp. I'll just check it up, okay?
I am already shared, ma'am.
Already shared, I didn't see. Let me just refresh. No, I didn't get.
Okay, ma'am, I am repeat share.
Okay. Just share it once again. I didn't get it. Just share it once again, okay? Yes, coming to our perspective. So someone asked why, how?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, based on two parameters, based on my knowledge, two parameters are Java is a secured programming language. In encapsulation and abstraction, these are the two parameters used in Java. So we can call it as secured programming language.
So in what parameters you can call it as?
Java is a secured programming language.
Okay, okay.
In encapsulation and abstraction, encapsulation, binding data or code into a single unit.
Okay, Suresh, got it. Yes, next, Gulshan, you wants to go on?
Ma'am, when we create the program, the byte code will be converted into a machine code.
Okay, that is one point we can collect, we can consider.
And the byte code is run only on JVM.
Yes.
So anywhere on JVM we can run this byte code.
Yes.
So that's why the Java programming is secure programming language.
Yes, yes. Okay. One point. Hello, yes, who is that? Rinit or Satyanarayana? Who wants to go on?
Me, ma'am.
Hello.
Rinit.
Ma'am, as you said, while you compile a .java file, a .class file will be created. These .class, the bytecode will be verified by the bytecode verifier. Only if the bytecode is proper, then it goes for the execution part. So yes, that is the one reason. And also, yes, Java does not support external pointers. It uses only exactly. JVM does the memory allocation part. So that is also another reason we can say Java.
Good, excellent. The most important 2 points you have covered it. Good.
Oh, ma'am,
yes, Sudhir, you wants to give some answer?
Ma'am, what is the question, ma'am? We are doing what with the database connectivity. Database connectivity we are doing, ma'am.
Nothing, just Ashish doubt was like what parameters we can say Java is secured programming language.
So using data heading and encapsulation, it's also a good part of secure data. Like using private methods and private variables and using data structure methods.
Okay, okay. So you raised one more point, like using access modifiers, we can make it secure.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So yes, Ashish, I hope you are clear. So I'll make somewhat clear. So here, first point is when we are telling it's a secure, yes, we need to validate whether on what parameters we can just tell it's a secure thing. First thing, it doesn't support pointers. Pointers is pointing towards address of something where Java doesn't support. So that improves its security. Next part is it is executing dot class file. That means bytecode is being executed. Your program code never been executed directly. So there again a security parameter is being there. And everything is objects and classes. So you need to have an object to call it upon and then it will be executed. Then comes with access. Then comes with modifiers. Then comes with encapsulation, abstraction. Almost everything in the Java, whatever you are using, having a level of security. Clear, Ashish?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good, Ashish. You need to ask this kind of questions where, you know, this will clear even others' doubts and even they'll get a good clarity on it. Good, yes, Ashish.
Ma'am. Thank you.
I'm expecting more questions in this format from you. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So yes, yes, guys. So where we are exactly? So I was asking some questions to you, right? So now your next question is: you want difference between C++ and Java? C++ and Java.
Ma'am, you are asking everyone or only newcomers?
You work out on yourself with the connectivity.
So I have done, ma'am.
Done. Okay, okay, that's great. Wow. Just
C++ is platform dependent. Java is a platform independent.
Mm-hmm.
C++ is using for developing system application.
Mm-hmm.
We can use Java for web-based mm-hmm. applications.
Mm-hmm.
C++ access modifier variable integer. They have different with Java. That means we have int string. They have C++ in character also. Something different.
Okay. Okay. Yes. That's great. Like, see, C++ and Java, a lot of differences you'll be having. Platform dependent and independent. Pointers, go-to statements, multiple inheritance, operator overloading, then compiler and interpreter, both were having in Java, but C++ it's having only compiler, call by value and call by reference, structure, union, thread support, documentation comment, inheritance tree, hardware and object orientation. Everything, every concept, almost you are having a lot of differences from C++ and Java. So here it supports there. It won't support, like in C++ it doesn't support, but here Java it is supported. So that is what the difference which you just gone through it. But like you're having other session for the interviews even. So a couple of basic things which I've asked it already. One more thing I just want to verify. Is there any difference in the Java main if we are writing public static and static public? Like public static void main we'll be writing, right? In the same way, static public void main if we write. Is there any difference between that and this? Will you get an error?
No, ma'am.
Oh,
no,
ma'am.
Are you sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that's right. There is no difference. Basically, for what you are using, there is no hierarchy. Just you are using for the purpose, public to make it scope, visibility. Static to avoid creation of object. That's it. So there is no sequence in that. Yes, Shashank, are you having any doubt?
Hello, ma'am. I have one doubt.
Yes.
Java is based upon a compiler and interpreter based language.
Yes.
But the main purpose of JIT compiler.
Yes.
I.
So you want to know what's the purpose of JIT compiler, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yep. Just in time compiler. It is used to improve the performance. It is basically used to improve the performance. JIT compiler parts of bytecode that have similar functionalities at the same time. At the same time, and hence reduces the amount of time needed for compilation. Here the term compiler refers to a translation from instruction code of a Java or JVM to instruction set of specific CPU. That means over here what you need to understand is, compiler means what? It is converting to bytecode, right? So here, when it's compiling to bytecode, what this JIT compiler will do, it will make in parts of similar functionalities at the same time. It won't do like one, this part is done, then this part, it won't do. Similar time, same time, it will just go on compiling similar part of code. This part, each and every part of code at the same time, it will just compile wherever it needs. So that here, time will be very less, time reduction is been happening. So it is not compiling
All the things like after one, it's not compiling. All the similar set of things, like all the methods were there. Yes, methods. It will just make it to bytecode. So in the similar functionalities, wherever exist in the code, it will be converting that in the same time. That is important. So it will just make the parts of the bytecode that have similar functionalities. This is how it is helped to improve the performance. So JIT compiler is used to improve the performance. Clear?
And JIT compiler in JVM or it is separate compiler?
No. Compiler in the sense, it's a kind of translator, right? From instruction set of JVM to instruction set of specific CPU. It's not a completely separate thing or something else. So basically, if you want to know in depth of JIT compiler, so you have a good clarity about JVM, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So you understood what is JVM and all, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, this JIT compiler, it is having performance that's fine, and it is like by compiling bytecode into native machine code at runtime. Where this bytecode will exist?
In JVM.
JVM. So this code, bytecode into native machine code, in the sense whatever exists in zeros and word, it will exist in it. It will convert into machine code. That is what JIT compiler does. So it won't convert from the code what we are writing to bytecode. From the code already bytecode has done, there again it will be going on to machine code.
Yes, ma'am. Interpreter will interpret just, and JIT compiler will convert bytecode into machine code.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Got it. So it is not. So what you need to think about JIT compiler, it is not going on with our code compilation, like whatever we are writing. It is converting bytecode, which is already done. That code, it is combined, like it is compiling to machine code.
Okay, ma'am.
So now you understood. Now is it part of JVM or separate?
It's a part of JVM.
From the JVM itself, it collect the bytecode and it will convert into the machine code.
Okay.
Yep. So here you will be having some details which I need to just ask. Almost like basic things were done. Almost done. So now let's execute some part of code. Let me share your screen. So any doubts until now? And whoever have completed the basic thing, I'll just share my screen and show you about object and classes. And then I'll give you a task to write the code. Please write the code. And you need to finish it now in the session itself. Okay. So yeah, this is the thing, basic code. This is the thing of the basic code. This is connectivity. List, which were not required. These all were not required for the basic task or the code. So let me just go with some. Okay, we are having only these things. So you are having all the JDBC details. Yep, fine. So what you need to do is, I'm just making changes in this code. Please observe it. So I'm just creating a couple of methods over here. So void display is a method which I'm just creating it. So inside it, I'm just using just a small print statement, system dot out dot some println. Yep. So inside it, just calling method or display method. Clear? So this method is done. Once this method is called, then obviously what happens is I need to get display method as a result. So for calling this method, I need to go with the creation of objects. Creation of object. For which class you need to create object where this method exists to display, void display?
In basic class.
So for basic class, you need to create an object. For that, class name space, given object name like obj, you can just take equals to with the new keyword. You have to give again basic class name. That's it. Done. So no parameters, nothing. You're not performing anything. Just you're creating an object for the class. Once object is done, you need to call this particular method. For that, obj.display. It's already there over here, display. Done. If you call this method, this display method has to be printed. Let me save it and execute it. Enter number, done. See, I got display method as an output. Now, it's in the same class. Yes, this is a process, but I don't want in the same class. I don't want in the same class. What I can do is I can go with other class. Public class. Give over here. Anyway, it's in the same package, so I don't want to make it as a public, just class. Some demo, I'm just creating class demo. Right, I'm just creating class demo. And over here, void display one. Over here, system dot out dot println. So here I'm just trying to display just a statement like display one method from other class. Done. So now this is completely separate. No main method, nothing is there. This is my separate class. I want this to be executed from the class where main method is there. This may be in other file even. Now use L is there. Capital L is there over here. So this is a file. I can just call from this file even to get this particular. I can just create it because in under same package. I can just create an object and I can just call this particular path. Once let me execute this in the same file, two classes were there. And in one class, a method is there. In one class, main method is there where I'm creating objects in the main method and I'm trying to call it up. So now why object dot display is done. So this object is particularly for basic class. Now, if one wants to execute a method from other class, what you need to do is you need to create object for that class. So where is my display one exist? In which class?
Demo.
So how to create the object for that demo class?
Demo obj is equal to
class name.
Demo class obj. Name. Any name you can give, object name, it's not yes, only yes. Obviously any name you can give.
Any name okay? We can give, yes.
Any name. So object one, then?
Equal to new demo.
Equals to new keyword.
Equals to new keyword. Then, shall I give basic demo. Over here or demo?
Demo.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Done. My object creation is done. So, to call display one, what the code I need to write?
Object dot
obj one dot method name. Method name.
Method name. Clear? Any doubts in these lines?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. I'm just saving it and then executing it. Done. Display method is done. Display one method from other class. Yeah, both are done. So now what I'll do is, yeah, this is clear for me. No issues. I want to execute the code from the same package. Okay. So I want execute or I want to run this particular class from here. Can I do it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So now just tell me the code, how I can do it.
We have to make the object of that class.
Okay. So use and capital L in class. Okay. Class name obj2 equals to new use L. The object is done. Next, what I need to do?
Obj2.
obj2 dot method name.
obj2 dot
method name.
Method name.
Method name.
Which I need to give? Main? Which I need to give? I'll show once again that class.
No, ma'am, we can't create
object. Ma'am, we don't need to. This is the static method, I think. Ma'am, it will call automatically, I think.
Okay, then I'll remove it, okay?
Yes,
ma'am. Now I'll just save and execute it, okay? Can I execute it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I didn't get. I didn't get it.
Yes, sir.
How can I get that? Let me do obj2 dot. The main method is there. Let me give. It's asking some arguments. Let me pass now. So, is it executed now? Now it will be executed or not? Let's execute and see. Am I getting it?
Yes.
Yes, I got it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. You got it.
Then why do you confuse when you are having no methods? Call main method.
Yes, ma'am.
That's it. Call it upon. Passing the arguments, give it as a null.
Null,
you can give null. Nothing you're passing, no input, no user input. If it is having some user input, give that user input in that place.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Because this is a doubt where you'll be getting while giving the code, while extension of the Java code and all. So what is this? Is only main method is there. How do I call that method? So no issue. It's a method. That's it. It's first of all a method. You can have calling option for any method using object by creation of the object. So you can call it on. But here the doubt would be what arguments I need to pass inside it. Because it is mentioned string args. You can pass null if you're having no user input. If you're having user input, you need to pass user input, whatever is there. Like if it is integer, pass it integer value. I hope it's clear to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So now your task is go creation of 4 to 5 classes. And one class, you should have main method. You need to create objects of the other 4 classes and you need to call the methods using that objects. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So you need to perform this task, guys. So it's up to you. Like, if you perform each and every task, for sure you'll be getting, and once the first lot of the interview itself, you will be get entered into your job. So it's about practice. It's a coding language. You need to have a lot of practice. If you practice, you will get a lot of doubts. Ask me doubts, utilize my knowledge, and then you will get on yourself. So I never tell, like, I won't stop you in between. Whenever you ask me doubt, I'll be available for you. Clear? So please try to practice. Lot of coding is required. Then only you can answer technical questions. So please try to go on. You need to have 5 classes. If it is in the form of system, that will be great. Like, if it is a calculator part of thing, like when you call one method, some calculation will be done. That can be very good way presenting in the form of system. It's up to you. You can present in the form of system, or you can go just the simple classes and all. I hope I'm clear to you. So now, yes, whoever joined like today and all, please continue with your thing. So already it's 8, right?
Yes.
It's done very quickly, 2 hours. Okay, guys, so just perform this task, and I just wanted to view it next. And the connectivity, who are there?
Yes, ma'am.
So remaining, please, you can just observe the connectivity, what is going on and everything. I don't tell to leave, so you can just observe, because it's nothing but gaining knowledge again. So yes, can you please share your screen, Sudhir?
Ma'am, give the access, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, it's done.
So, ma'am.
Sudhir, you used Hibernate? Hibernate you have used. Okay.
So this is my database.
Mm-hmm.
Page ID, mail, and name is there.
Okay.
So, This is my main class, the mapping class.
Mm-hmm.
And where I have mapped the database to the Java code.
Okay.
And here is the object where used to call.
Okay.
If I'm doing like get by ID 1, so it's giving me the ID 1, that is my name and email ID. Well, here it is. Add some data. I can use this thing to add some data in like 5. At ID 5, so I have to uncomment the save that else data.
Yep. Okay, that's great. Yes, Sudhir, that's fine. Sudhir, did you have any mock?
No, ma'am. Today I don't have any mock. 10 people are selected in that. My name is not there.
Okay, Sudhir.
So It will be tomorrow or day after tomorrow or what?
Maybe. It could be at any time. Be ready.
My name is also not there.
I know, Gulshan. Did you been perfect for JDBC concepts? Yes, Gulshan, have you practiced?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready now for JDBC event?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, Aishwarya.
Yes, Aishwarya.
Ma'am, today I done my interview.
Yes, no.
In the mock.
Yes, yes. How did it happen? Because I'll get your complete feedbacks and all things. I have given the means to make it as a interview, mock interviews. That's the reason I want everyone to be regular, because it's my thing where I need to give your names and I need to collect the feedbacks. I need to make again register. So please join regularly, whoever the new joiners will. Yes, Mohanta, how was your thing?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Some question is ma'am asking me, what is the difference between JDK, JR, JVM, and what is the difference between int and byte? And so giving a some question like palindrome number, if you output is a palindrome number, then you can find this number is the factorial or not. Give me this.
Did you given the code right?
Yeah, ma'am.
But you didn't reach the expected.
Hello.
Yes, you have. Do you feel like whatever the code you have given is right?
Yes, ma'am. I done this code and I saw this code from him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
And basic question.
So, Sudhir, not Sudhir, Mohanta, for you, a small suggestion is whenever a question is asked, try to understand, try to analyze the question and give the answer.
Okay.
So, your basic answers, everything was really given very good.
Okay.
Okay. That's a good sign, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, your basic answers, it's really good. Concept oriented, you're very good. While giving program, try to understand.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, try to understand exact question what they are asking. So what is input they are expecting and what is the output what they are expecting? For what input, what output you are expecting? If you have still a doubt, ask to the interviewer what kind of output you are expecting or what kind of input and then what output.
Okay,
from next time try to practice it. Clear? Yes, you need to analyze. You need to analyze individual question.
Yes,
clear, Mohanta? But I'm happy for you because your concepts were really good. Your basic answers, everything was really given very good way.
Okay. Thank you.
Why very slowly? Okay. You need to be happy for that. Be confident.
Sorry, ma'am. My mic is too long.
Your mic is low, not you, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Please try to concentrate on your communication. At any time, you may have a mock. Okay.
Yes.
Ma'am, today I had some words with Jaya, ma'am.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Ma'am told me that tomorrow is my mock interview.
Yes. 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 Yes,
ma'am. But what time? Time, ma'am didn't mention the time.
It's an internal mock, Ashish. Just to make you prepared for that. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, when was my internal interview?
If you are ready with your connectivities, it will be happen.
Ma'am, ready.
Ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then I should not say anything, concept is not clear or some kind of thing. Be prepared for that.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So then your mock will be done.
I'm also ready for that.
Shubham?
Yes, ma'am.
You're ready for that? Your concepts and everything was fine?
Perfectly, ma'am.
Perfectly. Then that's great confidence from your end.
Yes,
Yes, I'll be forwarding your name too. Still, anyone is ready?
Ma'am, Aishwarya.
Aishwarya already noted, Aishwarya. Why you are getting errors, Aishwarya, and even I got my number, I didn't get any kind of photo or something else. Please collect. I even told JM to give the number and all. You can collect it and you can send me what's issue you're facing. Whenever you're having a doubt, you just feel free to contact me. Okay, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am. Definitely.
At any time, I'll be available, Aishwarya. You need to worry, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I am one question another. Because, ma'am, I have given you some exam for this coding. But I'm this question cannot understand. That's why I'm one problem.
Okay, sure. I will be there, right? Whatever, wherever test, whatever thing, if you won't understand, I'm here for you. You can contact me.
Yes, ma'am. Your now contact number, please provide.
You don't have, I told Jaya ma'am to give you, because she asked, then I told, okay, pass on my number, then you'll be contacting.
Okay, ma'am.
From there, the number, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so, next, who want to go?
So, I'm done, ma'am. Am I done?
Yes, so then you can stop sharing your screen. And, yes, Shubham, please perform well.
Okay, ma'am.
Shubham P. Aishwarya, please concentrate, and Ashish, please be confident on the topics whatever you are performing. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Sure. Suresh Babu, you need to concentrate still. You need to clear up your concepts. So, is anything done? Any mock is done for you?
No, ma'am.
I know, ma'am.
I am also ready for.
You are ready, ma'am. Please concentrate on your vocabulary.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you will have mock, don't worry.
Yes, ma'am. I need to practice.
Yes, just practice. Just practice, okay? So don't think you're speaking something in somebody else's language. So feel free to communicate.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? Just feel free. So remove your tension part. Then you'll be very good enough to give your interview.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, all the best, Sudhir, Gulshan, Ashish, Shubham, Aishwarya, Suresh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Have to give well. So I should not hear concept or program. Logic implementation is important. Logic building is important. Whatever question, try to analyze properly. Remove your tension part and give it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So almost we are demo, out of time. Yes, guys. So whoever are performing, maybe this session would be a drill for your basics of first class. So don't think that, whoever joined due to them, it's got repeated or something else. Don't worry. It will be a drill for you how to give the basic questions, because basic questions never been skipped even at top level interviews. Even for experience, they will go from the basic itself. So basic questions were very much important for you to understand the coding basics, okay? Yes, guys, that's all for today. And I hope everyone to be joined for tomorrow also, whoever joined the first day today. So each and everything will be explained. Lot of questions, lot of code snippets, lot of games in technical perspective we are being played. We need to brush up and we need to make you technically strong. And your support also important. Your support is just you need to join the session. That's it. If you join the session in time, that's it. Success will be yours. Clear, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
For today, we'll meet up again tomorrow at 6. And all the best. You 6.
Thank you.
Gulshan, Ashish, Shubham, Aishwarya, Suresh. Can you see our number? Okay, fine.
Ma'am, my number.
Not your number. They asked you mine. Who will ask your number now?
Yes.
Okay. Yep, it's done. See, please try to give your names, okay, while asking your questions. If not, I may not respond to you. Just give 6 to 8 from Million Heights, then your name. Then I'll be responsive to you, okay? Yes, that's all for today, guys. So we'll meet up tomorrow at 6 p.m. Did you note it? Will I end the meeting?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for the day. We'll meet up again tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am. Good night.
Good night. And tomorrow, with full of confidence on the topics.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Good night.
Good night, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Good night.